gets a few stops here.
When you looked at the roster again, we talked about it before the game, when you talked about playing a lot of guards, being small, did you try to wear down the big forward like that? Did Marcus Allen, a really good player, double team them early and often? Because I think he's showing up.
Yeah, we knew they would get a little bit tired with each other. But they're going to be stopped.
How did you feel playing without Rudy?
I didn't like it, but I think you guys responded better. I think you kind of did that. Okay. Yeah, exactly. Okay. Some of those guys were.
What's his story?
Trey was out of town.
He will be back. That's a big bonus for you, isn't it?
Yeah. He didn't play last year, so he kind of.
I was kind of curious about what Tony and I talked about this so often, and I know a lot of the viewers are curious. How much coaching is done in these leagues? Because, you know, sometimes some of these games do look like pickup games, but we want you tonight. You and Alvin were really coaching it up, and you coach high school basketball. How much coaching actually is there?
Well, there's a lot of coaching, and there's a lot of management. There's some strategy in there, and also just
more athletic. Yeah, I do. I talked about that before with Mark, but you know, you don't really have 4 or 5 days to practice, so it becomes much more of a psychological trying to keep people happy when you're coaching. They have guys who are coaching 5 days a week, and if they do something wrong, then of course you say, we work on it, you should be better a year.
I've been fortunate to have the same
As far as your bench is concerned, we'll wrap it up right after this. We'll get one of the star players here in just a second. But when you have a short bench, is that a concern as well when you're coaching up the game?
Oh, definitely, especially when it's
Well, we will see you Thursday night. You have the first game on Thursday against National Fire Protection. Should be a great game, and we give you a Thursday back. Should be an added weapon for you guys. So we wish you the best of luck on Thursday night. What a terrific performance we've got. I'd like to see more of it on Thursday at least, as we are joined by Sean Brodus from Sports Strategy Partners. Congratulations on the game. Now, we talk about the guard play. We talk about comparing you guys with Golden State. Is this kind of like Riley Curry now with Steph Curry bringing his daughter to the game?
My daughter comes to most of the games. I thought I'd bring her out here tonight.
Well, she's a lot prettier.
Definitely. Let's get it from her mind.
For this game, and again, both teams will send a key player or two guys in the community. So for you and your brother, we've watched you guys so many years here in the summer league. What was your mindset before the game?
Just run. Because Mark was telling us to get out there and run. You know, like, coming towards the end of the game, you're not going to be able to stay with it. So we just pushed the tempo and just kept it at a fast pace for us.
You guys had a 7-point lead in the halftime, 50-43. It was a close game in the second half. They actually had a little lead over you guys. I think a 2 or 3-point lead mark had been interested. About 7 or 8 minutes left in the game, you guys really made your move, and it seemed that the team was a factor. Did you guys notice you guys wearing them down? And what was going through your mind when Clark had these games for
you? Just to keep playing. We still had a lot of time left, so we just got to keep our composure and fight through it. We knew that, you know, once we start wearing down the big defenses, that we just keep pushing. We had a bunch of guards out there. Pretty much all 5 of our players were all guards. He was a big guy, but he can play on the wing for us, and we were able to spread out for Martin a little bit. But all we did was we helped out a lot with double teams, and we just helped out.
Now let me ask you, how often do you practice your shooting? Because, you know, obviously, you practice extremely well, and it's very difficult to keep the 3-point shot well. I've always said, you know, 3-point shooters are like the weather, hot today, cold tomorrow. So you were very hot tonight. How often do you practice during the season?
Well, I practice every day, whether it's my ball handling or my shooting. I do pretty much everything every day. It's what I do for my living. And
I have to make sure that I keep my skills up.
Well, I think people have to make, I hate to make a generalization, but I think people have to understand practice makes perfect. The more you practice, the better you get. That's just a simple rule that people have to understand. So obviously, you making your shots tonight was a direct result of your practice. Also, you have to check it out. It's a practice that really helps you feel good.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Because everybody only sees the finishing product. You see us whenever we are in the game. They only see what leads up to the hours in the gym that we actually spend just practicing on our craft, you know. And I'm not a shooter. That's not my best strength in my game. I'm more of a penetrator, and I like to get people involved. And I'm also a scoring point guard. I always have been, but hitting my three-point shot, it helps out a lot because now people got to play me close, and I can do my quickness to get around them whenever there's a mismatch on.
You said shooting is not your strength. You could have pulled up with that. Now, you said also a minute ago, and I was not aware of this. I know you played in college, you played great in high school, but you said this is how you make your living. Are you playing professionally?
You can right now? No, I've been playing seven years. I'm going on 8 years playing in Europe. I played 1 year in Romania, a year in Ukraine, and the rest of my years in Lithuania. So, last year was actually my best season of my career so far. I got point guard of the year this past season. My team got a Euro Cup berth, and it was a great year for me individually and for my team. So right now, I'm just waiting to find next year.
Do you have any idea of where you might be playing?
I might end up in Poland. I'm just waiting to see what the ideal situation is in my family.
Well, good luck to you. I mean, you really put on a good show for us.
Thank you.
It's been fun watching you play. We'll get to see more of it on Thursday. We're probably appreciating that again. Great game, and we'll look forward to you guys will be in the first semifinal on Thursday.
Thanks for taking your daughter.
Maybe we can talk to you again after that game as well.
This is my daughter, Kaya, right here.
Hi. Good job. All right, thanks for joining us. Appreciate that. And an exciting game and a convincing victory for Walt Strategy Partners as they win. Going away, convincing victory again. Thursday at 10 o'clock, semifinal number one. And Walt Strategy with Julian Sensley against National Fire Protection. I know National Fire Protection is the higher seed. I kind of give a little bit of an edge to Walt Strategy based on tonight.
Oh, you're going out on a limb, are you?
A little bit.
I'll see you Thursday.
Second game, not exactly sure. I think that's going to be giving the chosen few and electricity supply. But we've seen so many great games over the years here. We invite you to join us back Thursday at 6 o'clock on Olelo TV, right here at Manoa Rec. Saturday, the championship game over at Marino on Collins Toledo Court. That's got to be a thrill for you coming up on Saturday, announcing the game on your court.
Yeah, it sure will. It definitely will.
Well, we'll look forward to that. But again, first things first, Thursday, semifinal. In both games on Olelo TV. We thank you for joining us. We will see you Thursday at 6 o'clock right here on Olelo TV. Have a great night.